JRA 501, Update Cherokee Nitrogen Plant Explosion, posted at 10:40 p.m. November 13, 2012, in the WHNT News 19. Colbert County, Alabama, there has been an explosion at the Cherokee Nitrogen Plant in Colbert County. Okay, officials say it was a minor explosion, but it caused a big impact, which is why residents across the shoals were able to feel it. Plant manager is currently assessing the damage. They confirm that one person was injured in the explosion. It's not known how many people were on site. The plant operates as Cherokee Nitrogen Division and produces ammonia, regular nitric acid, ammonium nitrate solution, and prill, urea, UAN solution, and specialty ammonia, ammonium nitrate solutions. The plant also produces high purity ammonia for refrigeration and metallurgical applications. Okay. So, Cherokee Nitrogen Plant is a Superfund site in Alabama. Scorecard profiles nearly 1,300 federal Superfund sites scheduled for cleanup on the National Priorities List, commonly known as the Federal Superfund Program. The law treats these as some of our nation's worst toxic waste sites and makes them eligible for long-term remediation. Contamination at Superfund sites results from improper handling of waste and toxic materials, often spanning many decades. Some Superfund sites are old waste disposal facilities, while others are various types of industrial production facilities at which unauthorized dumping or inadvertent spills occur. About 11 million people in the U.S., including 3 to 4 million children, live within 1 mile of a federal Superfund site. So why, if you've got 3 to 4 million children living within 1 mile of a federal Superfund site, why would they let them go long-term remediation? Why wouldn't they push to have them cleaned up immediately? Kind of logical question, sorry. The Agency for Toxic Substances and Diseases Registry reports that about half of the NPL sites assessed from 1992 through 1996 present a hazard to human health with the highest likelihood of exposure through contaminated groundwater and soil. Of the 30 hazardous substances found most often at these sites, 18 are known or suspect human carcinogens, and virtually all are associated with non-cancer health effects, such as toxicities to the liver, kidney, reproductive systems, including birth defects and low birth weight. Superfund sites such as Love Canal in New York, Rocky Flats, Colorado, Wells G&H in Woburn, Massachusetts, have brought increased public attention to this important environmental issue. Well, hopefully Cherokee will do the same. Okay, they do have scorecards. So, let's take a look at Cherokee Nitrogen's scorecard. Here we have the cleanest, best facilities in the U.S. Here's the percentile of dirtiest, worst facilities in the U.S. Section 1, chemical releases or waste generation. And we have total environmental releases at 80 or 90% of being the worst in the U.S. Air releases, 70 to 80. Water releases, 90 to 100% in the red. Land releases, 40 to 50. Total production related waste, 90 to 100%. Release weighted by potential environmental health impacts, non-cancer risk score, air and water releases, 50 to 60%. Releases sorted by suspected health effects. Air releases, suspected cardiovascular or blood toxicants, 10 to 20%. Water releases of suspected cardiovascular or blood toxicants, 90 to 100%. Air releases of suspected kidney toxicants, 10 to 20%. Water releases of suspected kidney toxicants, 60 to 70%. And then the rest of these are all 70 to 80%. And we have air releases of suspected gastrointestinal or liver toxicants, water releases of suspected gastrointestinal or liver toxicants, air releases of suspected neurotoxicants, water releases. They have an awful lot of bad scores on their water. Water releases of suspected neurotoxicants, air releases of suspected reproductive toxicants, water releases of suspected reproductive toxicants, air releases of suspected respiratory toxicants, water releases of suspected respiratory toxicants, air releases of suspected skin or sense organ toxicants, and water releases of suspected skin or sense organ toxicants. I'm sure there's many that are much worse, although this does sound pretty bad. Their water releases and their water releases suspected of cardiovascular or blood toxicants, 90 to 100% in the red. Worst in the U.S. Okay, well, my prayers go out to all these people. This was felt miles around and actually did cause damage miles around. So while it's being reported as a minor explosion, I try to tell that to the people that live miles away. Prayers go out, and as always, God bless.